This video will explore what telemedicine is, how it works, why it is important, and how we can bridge the gaps to improve telemedicine. Welcome to the world of telemedicine, the latest innovation of healthcare. Let's jump right into the world of exploring what telemedicine is. Telemedicine is a medical activity concerning the element of distance, which in translation means providing healthcare from a distance. Telemedicine relies on the use of electronic information technology such as computers, cameras, video conferencing software, satellites, wireless communication such as phones and tablets, and the internet. Telemedicine is also known as telehealth. The use of telemedicine drastically increased during the pandemic. As we all know, the COVID-19 pandemic affected over 18.3 million people worldwide. With the social distancing restrictions and the increased susceptibility to the virus, our world was thrown upside down. Tasks like going to the doctor, filling prescriptions, and going to the emergency room were much more complicated. Telehealth during the first 6 months of the pandemic was used at an ultimate high, particularly for high-income countries such as America, Europe, and Western Pacific regions. The increase of telemedicine during this time assisted in the active management of patients with COVID-19, making it safer and easier to survey, admit, and diagnose patients. In addition, telemedicine during the pandemic not only helped patients, but also helped medical schools deliver medical education to permit students to keep on track with achieving their education requirements promptly despite challenges associated with the pandemic. Now, who would benefit from telemedicine? Well, older individuals who can't leave their homes due to mobility issues or who are incredibly sick can benefit from this technology as they can receive care right from their home. Telemedicine also benefits immunocompromised patients by reducing their risk of acquiring infectious diseases in doctor's offices, clinics, and hospitals. In addition, millennials are all about technology. We care about convenience and often like to do as much as possible with a touch of our phones. Telehealth increases accessibility to healthcare, can be less expensive compared to traditional healthcare in some cases, and provides convenience, making it the next big thing for generations to come. But overall, anyone and everyone can use telemedicine, regardless if you are medically or socially unable to see a provider in person. Whether you are tech savvy or not, telemedicine could be right for various types of individuals. Telemedicine can be used in various settings to help provide healthcare to patients, such as hospitals, clinics, nursing homes, doctor's offices, and even one's own living room. Telemedicine does require technology, and a provider needs a computer with a microphone and camera, a smartphone or tablet with a secure health insurance portability and accountability ACT compliant platform to operate the telemedicine visit. Video conferencing tools must enable encryption, access controls, and audit log. Encryption is needed to prevent unauthorized access to protected health information and ensure that sensitive data is unreadable to others. Access control is needed to ensure that the right users can access medical information. Audit logs help to track who has access to what information and how long they have that access to protect against stolen personal information. Examples of electronic health record systems include Allscript, Cerner, and Epic. When video calling, most popular applications are allowed, such as Apple FaceTime, Google Hangouts, Zoom, and Skype. To perform telemedicine visits, providers need to ask if anyone else is in the room and receive permission from the patients for these individuals to be in the virtual room before beginning the assessment. Then, the patient only needs a computer, smartphone, or tablet with a microphone and camera, and the software to video. Now that you know the basics of telemedicine, let's go over some benefits. The first benefit is that it can improve equal access to healthcare, such as increasing access for people that live in remote or rural areas. Quality of care increases as there are fewer errors and patient satisfaction has overall been reported to increase. Convenience, efficiency, and comfort increase as it is easier to get in contact with a health professional. Control of infectious diseases also improves, as people that are sick are staying within their own home and are not out and about. It can reduce everyone's risk of catching harmful pathogens. Although there are great benefits of telemedicine, there are some drawbacks that need a lot of improvement. The first drawback is that telemedicine is heavily used in developed countries, but developing countries' populations are much higher and would benefit significantly from telehealth. Developing countries need more healthcare resources and easy access to technology, making telemedicine non-existent in many areas of the world. However, if we can increase access to technology and educate residents about telemedicine, it can increase its use, benefiting communities. The second drawback is the need for more patient-provider relationship, which is vital for an accurate assessment. The last drawback we will be discussing is the need for physical assessments that can be conducted using telemedicine. As the provider is not physically in contact with the patient, they cannot do a vital sign assessment. They are limited with what physical exams can be conducted. To combat this, some patients may need a weight scale, blood pressure cuff, pulse oximeter, and a thermometer to assess the individual better. As technology keeps advancing, telemedicine will continue to expand and improve at providing healthcare from a distance. One way to increase telehealth is remote patient monitoring. When a patient wears a device that transmits information to a patient's phone and helps them keep track of their health information, which will then be directly sent to their physician. Another technological advancement is health apps with artificial intelligence that can detect patient trends and prompt them to take proactive action before showing any symptoms of illness. Now that you have learned more about telemedicine, tell us your opinions in the comment section below. Whether you would use telemedicine and how you think our futures will change with telehealth becoming more popular day by day. Thank you for watching and listening about the emergence of telemedicine.